your penultimate Sunday fix of BBLB for this series.
We've got 9 short days left of BB11, but worry not, as the housemates discovered on Friday night that play will be seeing a whole lot more action from some of the biggest and best housemates of all time after they get the boot in. Ultimate Big Brother, everybody!
It's exciting times ahead, George. Mm-hmm. I, for one, I'm very excited. Now, we can reveal that 4 housemates will be evicted this Friday. The final, which Josie has already won a ticket to, will take place on Tuesday, the 24th of August, which is also the launch night of Ultimate Big Brother.
Excited? You should be.
One lady who'll be watching from the sidelines, though, is Jo, who's here with us today, along with Issa. We'll be joined by the girl whose X Factor dreams were crushed by the power of Jedward. It's Lucy Jones.
Zig and Zag talk Kylie and Victoria Beckham with Big Brother 2 winner Mr. Brian Dowling.
We'll be taking a look at yesterday's Mexican taco hell task with Darth Naga.
Journalist Polly Vernon is here to talk Ultimate Big Brother speculation.
And the chart-topping Roll Deep are here to play us out.
So, Jo's journey has ended prematurely. This is her Big Brother story.
I don't know why you would have missed it, but if you did, this is what happened to Jo. The housemates picked her.
Number one.
She said this.
That's the main part of coming in here, to just come in and just get stuck in and just enjoy it.
Which is ironic, because she did a lot of this.
This is 4 days in a row.
Said she wanted to go.
Just come in to say that I want to go home.
And then she decided to stay.
I'm not going
to
leave.
She got kind of mad because of this.
It makes me kind of see you a bit different.
That's fine.
And then she said this.
The sooner I get evicted out of this place, the better, you know.
You agree?
Jo! They're really booing me!
And then she left. And that was Jo's time on BB.
Before we meet Jo, it's time to say hello to a man who's agreed to capture our cougar in this week's Evicted Depicted. It's Breeze from Roll D.
Yes, Breeze! Right. Breeze, have you got the skills to get the best drawing on that wall?
I'll give it a shot.
Are you any good at art, Breeze?
I'm all right. I'm all right.
I think he's quietly confident. He's just not giving too much away.
All right. Are you ready to meet our 8th evictee of Big Brother 11, everybody?
Yes!
She lasted 20 days, 23 hours, 37 minutes and 51 seconds in the house, and seeing as she didn't have any prey in there, we've decided to give her not one, but 2 sexy hunks to get her cougar claws into. Please welcome to the BBLB boudoir, Jo, everybody! Hey, isn't that right, Jo?
That's
actually should have been
too,
exactly about time too, indeed. Now you were given a pretty hard time in there, weren't you?
I was, definitely.
And you were definitely given a hard time when you came out. Were you surprised?
Yeah, really. I don't know what they expected me to do when I had no prey in there. So I'm happy to see that you've indulged me today.
You down, man. You know what? There's no way that man there can feed you grapes if he doesn't have grapes in his mouth.
Jo, you're living the dream right now, aren't you?
I am.
Look at their pants. I can't believe it. They've got tongues on the run and everything. Look, my toes are pointed. As we saw in last night's show, the other housemates seemed convinced that you were going. So did that ruin your last day in there?
Partly, because leading up to it, there was a lot of speculation and talk about it.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it was a bit sad.
You seemed quite agitated in last night's show when we saw you call them cockroaches.
Oh. Yeah, and I was swearing loads. I should have been given an ASBO. Did you see me? I had a hoodie on and trainers. But, yeah, I enjoyed my stay there. There was difficult times, but the bottom line, I really enjoyed it and it was good and I'm glad I had the experience.
All right, well, let's have a quick look at how the eviction crowd responded to you on Friday night.
What went wrong for Jo is she's quite a lot older than some of the more interesting housemates, so she probably was a bit boring, didn't do much.
She was boring!
Yeah, she was rubbish. She didn't do anything. She made me fall asleep.
One of the interesting things she did was cry at JJ when he gave her a hug.
Well, she was meant to be a bit of a cougar and she didn't exactly do anything in the house. Totally moaning all the time. And she wanted to go anyway, so she's left out.
I think actually Jo's
problem was this last week. She'd just been crying a lot, she'd wanted to leave. I mean, I identify with Jo because she's my age and I feel like her, young at heart. I think we're quite similar in that respect and we like dancing and we like going out and I liked her. I thought she was nice.
So Jo, Davina seemed to like you, the rest of them, not so much.
Yeah, I think, for one, this cougar thing, there obviously was no prey for me to anyone to even flirt with as a bit of banter. There wasn't that. And also, I am 41. I am fun-loving, but I am 41. So I don't know if they wanted me to be like a performing seal or... I'm 41 at the end of the day, so right. I'm going to mess about, but...
Up to a point.
Yeah, up to a point.
Jo, I think there's somebody who just wants to give you something there.
Oh. So, Jo, before you went in the house, you did sell yourself as the cougar. And as you probably know, Big Brother has their very own cougar who has a message for you.
Thank you.
Hello, Jo. Uber Cougar here. Despite what other people say, I have been pleased with your performance in the Big Brother house. You were constantly glamorous. You always spoke your mind. And given that your choice of male prey included two married men, a tattooed child, a gay conspiracy theorist, the king of the nerds, the world's dullest boxer, and a crab-eyed Beckham obsessive, I'm not surprised you chose to stay away. Well done, darling. Well done.
Oh, well, she loved you, Jo. Would you have gone for it if there was any available fit men in there?
Yeah, I'm naturally a flirty character. Right. You know, there doesn't have to be anything in it, but I love to flirt. So, yeah, definitely.
You, Laura, and Rachel all seem quite inhibited when you're in there. Was it strange kind of trying to be yourself when you've gone in late and also you know who the favourites are?
Yeah, that did definitely play a part, definitely. And it was sometimes quite hard to form a bond with people because they were already quite tight-knitted as it was.
Yeah.
So that did cause part of the problems, I think, for me.
And what about the curse of Mario? Because there's a lot of speculation. If you get close to Mario, then you're coming out. And you kind of were friends with him and now you're sitting out here.
Yeah. Mario and myself laughed at that. Because it definitely is a curse of Mario.
Yeah, let's have a little... Should we have a little look at the curse of Mario, guys? Yeah. Remind ourselves.
Jo, I don't want you to be evicted.
It's out of your control. Anyway, anyone that you seem to befriend gets dashed out. Haven't you noticed that? Poor Nathan.
Nathan!
Sunshine.
Sunshine!
Poor Iffy.
Iffy!
Ben.
Ben!
Bye, everyone.
Ben.
My hours are numbered, never mind days.
Jo!
Hold on. Come on.
I'm so sorry.
So all of his mates get kicked out, but he manages to stay. How does he do it?
He's lovely. Mario's just a really nice guy. How he manages to stay in, I don't know. I don't know how he manages
Magic
it.
Mario.
Magic
now,
Mario.
Jo, you won't know this, but before you went in, we had a tea leaf reader read your tea leaves. Yeah, she was called Cassandra Eason. She made some incredible predictions. They turned out to be pretty extraordinary. Have a look at these.
Unfortunately, it's a big bear jumping up. So one of the ladies who's been there a time is going to get her claws out.
Don't worry, babe.
How about
interesting.
That? Interesting. Interesting. Now, you were very diplomatic about Corinne on Friday night. Do you still feel the same now?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah?
Yeah, I definitely think that...
You called her a seal and a performing monkey in the
Did
newspaper.
I?
Yes.
Did
that
I?
Must have been in the heat of the moment.
Sorry, Corinne, and to your family and friends. Because it's just a show. It's just a game show, isn't it?
It's all panto.
It is, very much so.
Right, we were so impressed with Cassandra's reading that we've invited her back to see what the future holds for you now. After that, you've left the house. Welcome, Cassandra.
Hello. Cassandra.
How are you doing?
Fine, thank you.
Is that the cup you want to hand over?
These are Jo's tea leaves.
Here's one she drank earlier. Have a look at that, Cassandra.
Absolutely.
Quick as you can.
Well, Jo, you're going to start off presenting radio show, young celebrity,
but no, big dragon rearing up. And then going to run a club in Spain. But yes. I've got a kangaroo, an older kangaroo. So you're going to end up with an older Australian man.
Oh! Does that, how does that sound to you, Jo?
The club
an older side. Man rather than a younger man?
I'm more interested in the club side of it. I want to be a DJ anyway, so yeah, I like it.
All right, Jo, very quickly, who do you think is going to go on Friday?
Dave, maybe Andrew, maybe JJ.
A whole bunch of them then.
Yeah.
All right, Dani, give her a big round of applause.
Thank you.
Jo,
thank
everybody. You. We're going to be seeing more of her later on in the show. Thank you very much, Jo. Thank you, boys.
Right. Can you save your energies, though? Because it's my turn next. Don't panic too much. Don't give it too many grapes. I want to go as well. That's it for part one. Make sure you join us after the break when I will be bringing you all the latest news headlines live from inside the house. I can't wait. I'm going in the garden.
Welcome back to BBLB. It's 11:42. Look what Bree's from Roll Deep knocked up. Look at Jo there. Doesn't she look beautiful? It's not bad. It's not bad. He's giving old Keith Lemon a run for his money. Yeah, still to come, Zig and Zag talk being the only gay in the village with Brian Dowling. But first, over to Emma. She could not be more excited. She's live in the Big Brother garden with all the news headlines.
I'm in the garden. Right, at 2:48 yesterday afternoon, Mario, JJ and Dave took part in the Taco Hell Task, a Mexican eat-off that really heated up the house. If you're currently eating your breakfast, I suggest you push it to one side and maybe think about having it later.
It's not worth going through
that. It's not worth that.
It is, Mario. It's a party for all of us.
This is good stuff.
Water, water now, water. You'd have to travel all around the way to the bottom of England in any time.
Glory.
Come on, Molly, sir. Come on, Molly. Get it out. Get it out, Molly. Better open in, more better open in.
I strongly suggest you don't try that at home because it didn't look like the love of God bubbling in Dave's belly to me. At 6:27 last night, Steve took it upon himself to make a few predictions about who was going to make it to the final, one of which was pretty controversial.
I don't say this very often, but I feel by the grace of God. Yeah. I don't know why I say that, but I feel by the grace of God, we... including me, you and Corin, could well be sitting on that setting next week.
I don't think Howard's that
bad. No, I think you could be. No, I think you could
be. I think it's going to be...
I don't normally get like that a lot and I've got goosebumps.
If there's no John James in the final, I'll be one stunned mullet. Housemates were rewarded for Dave, JJ and Mario's heroic efforts in the Taco Hell Task with a Mexican-themed party last night at 8:05. And as usual, it descended into chaos.
Word.
Oh no! Oh no! Textbook error.
Oh, the bell bell.
This is going to be so rigged.
It seems like Dave's got some issues he needs to work there. Calm down, big man. If you want all the latest news, including a look at Sam's truly revolting party trick, then log on channel4.com/Big Brother. Now, though, it's over to George, who's feeling hot, hot, hot.
Here, Emma. So yesterday, Dave, JJ and Mario took part in a Mexican eat-off. JJ was the first to finish, although after a vomit or five, Dave and Mario also managed to clear their plates. To find out what all the fuss is about, I am now joined by a man who's so chili-obsessed, he even has his favourite brand of hot sauce tattooed on his arm. It's Death Narg, Darth Narger, everybody. Look at that.
Hello.
Get, see?
That's Who Dares Burns.
Who Dares Burns, everybody. Darth, can you tell us what it is that you do?
I'm a product reviewer for the Chili Foundry. I do chili reviews, sauces,
He's
things like
that.
He's
the big guy in the chili world, everybody, yeah? Where did you get your name from?
Actually, my girlfriend gave it to me because I'm a big Star Wars fan and the Naga is my favourite pepper.
So you put those together, Darth Naga, love what you've done there. Do you think they cope well with the challenge?
I do, actually. I saw it last night. I mean, there was a little bit of vomiting, but generally...
Dave was doing quite a lot of vomiting, but he managed to work out a good routine where he vomited and then went back into the food. I was impressed.
It was quite like, clear it out, put it back in, clear it out.
Have you ever vomited like that off the back of chili?
Once or twice, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, one time I ate some chili and then I needed to get out of my system, so I went downstairs, vomited, passed out, woke up 20 minutes later naked with my clothes in a pile next to me.
Huh?
I don't know how it happened.
That's my kind of party, guys. That is my kind of party. In terms of fire, what's the hottest chili that you've personally got?
I've personally eaten, there was a chili in the news back in April known as the Infinity Chili.
Yeah.
And in a pub.
Did Darth
in
go
Cove,
in on it?
Yeah. I went in whole, a video's on YouTube.
This wasn't the 20
whole
minutes naked in the bathroom story.
No. Not
different
time. No video of that.
Okay. If you had to compare our housemates' chilies, who would you say which chili is most like Sam Pepper?
Sam Pepper is very much like a habanero for the simple reason that you get an initial burn.
Okay.
You get an initial burn and then there's a proper niggly, annoying burn after that.
Okay, that's perfect for Sam Pepper then.
Yeah, exactly.
And which pepper would John James most be like?
John James? Well, he would be like the Naga.
Really? Your favourite then?
My favourite.
Yeah.
Simply because, he is my favourite in the house. He's very fiery, up front, in your face, just like the Naga.
Right, OK, that's the Naga. What about Steve?
Steve, very much like a jalapeno.
OK.
Initial burn, but nothing.
Looks interesting and then just fades off.
Fades off, does nothing.
Yeah, that's Steve, all right. So, and then finally, Josie.
Josie, a good all-rounder. The bird's eye chili, simply because there's a nice punch of heat. And it's a gentle, warm feeling.
I just lingers with you. Nice fine for Josie. Now, we want to know if you really are as fearless a chili consumer as you make out to be. So we've pitted you against Roll Deep's number one chili man over here, Josie K.
Okay.
We're going to have a Mexican chili off. J2K, you're feeling confident?
I
bet you're glad the boys picked you, eh?
Yeah.
Have you been drinking plenty of milk?
I had a couple of sips.
Right, OK, and apparently the yoghurt's good too. Water's completely the wrong thing, by the way, guys. I can't believe we had them drinking water in the house. Are you ready, guys? When the klaxon sounds, I want you to get tucked into this. Here we go. Let's hit the buzzer. Start chomping, boys.
OK.
J2K's gone in on the burrito first. Don't try this at home, everybody. There's lots of chili in here. I'll tell you just how much chili, actually. In here we've got chili flakes, 2 pots of, everybody. Lots of bird's eye chilies, 10 packs. Hot sauce, 4 bottles. How are we doing, Jay? Oh, it's just kicked in. Some scotch bonnets. How are we doing, Darth? That's pretty lively, isn't
that's
it?
That's really warm.
Huh?
Really warm.
Interesting that Darth went in on the chili con carne first. How are you doing with the burrito, J2K?
It's chewy, man.
It's hot.
Go and swallow it.
All right, boys, you keep doing that rather than the meat. It's now up to the workshop for Zig and Zag, who are joined by a man who was voted best Big Brother winner not once, but twice, Mr. Brian Dowling. Look at J2K's all over the place.
Struggling.
Yes! We like winners on this show, and not only has this man won Big Brother, he is Big Brother's favourite housemate ever.
Yes.
Ever.
Yay. It could get evil, folks. It's Brian Dowling!
Now, Brian, you were the winner of BB2.
I was, yes.
That was ages ago.
Long time ago.
What's it like being back
in... Can I just say that I was only this tall when Brian Dowling won Big Brother 2, and now I am this tall.
Yes!
When I won Big Brother 2, I was skinny too, so a lot changes.
You were voted the viewers' favourite Big Brother housemate of all time.
Yeah,
twice.
I know. Twice. Twice, yeah.
What
Weird.
Have you got that Nadia doesn't have?
Well, I just think I did the show 9 years ago
when
it was a bit more fun.
Right.
And I think it wasn't as intense.
Mm-hmm. True.
And I think it reminds people of a happier time.
Okay.
And plus, obviously, I'm a nice person and people obviously liked me, which is good. So.
That's good.
They do.
Well, look, okay, you talk about fun. What were your favourite memories from your time in the house?
I kind of enjoyed nominating a little bit, which is probably weird.
Oh, that's right.
You know why? Because I was obviously a lot younger.
Yeah.
And I think if I went back in now, I think I'd be a little bit more vicious.
Because
I used to say, ooh, I get on with someone else better.
Right.
Now I'd be like, I really hate him. He needs to leave.
Wow.
You know what I mean? So I think I'd be, because I'm older now.
Yeah. Less tolerant. Cut to the chase.
Basically, yes.
I like it.
Right. Yeah.
More evil.
What was the worst thing that Big Brother made you do?
The worst thing they made me do. Oh, see, back in the day, I mean, our tasks were pretty easy.
Compared to nowadays.
We had to train a dog how to sit down. And we're like, it's a dog. What are we going to do? I don't know what to do.
You didn't like it when Josh arrived in the house.
I'm sorry, who?
Josh.
I have no idea what you're talking
about. Oh!
No, okay, let me set the record straight here with you two, right?
Yeah.
I didn't like him, not because he was a gay too.
Right.
That's because he was a gay is kind of partial of it.
Yeah. Okay.
But we just didn't get on.
Was it not that you just wanted to be the only gay in the village?
Well, yes.
Yes.
Is it true, though, that Little Britain's sketch was based on you and Josh?
That is true.
What?
Actually, it's actually based on me.
Wow.
I was lucky enough through two friends of mine to go for dinner with David Walliams.
Yeah.
And he told me they had an idea of a gay character called David.
Yeah.
And they weren't sure what to do with him. And then they watched me on Big Brother. And when Josh came in, I was like, but I'm the only gay in the Big Brother house. This is so unfair.
Yeah.
So I am David, the only gay in the village.
What? Isn't that great? How cool is that? Yeah.
You've gone from Big Brother housemate to bona fide celebrity, right? Well,
right.
Who's the most famous person you have in your mobile phone?
Oh, I love this.
Tell us who.
Who is it?
Well, Kylie did call me once.
What?
Yes,
Kylie Minogue.
Kylie Minogue. Victoria Beckham's called me.
What?
Yeah, to do favours for them.
What?
Yeah, that's who I hang with now, guys.
That is so celebrity.
Come here. Despite being so famous, you still hang out with Narinder.
Yeah.
Why?
Okay. You're being really mean because actually the best thing from the house, seriously, and this is shockingly, has been she's been a friend for life.
Do you fancy going back into the house then?
Do you know what? I've been asked this a lot recently.
Yeah.
And it would really kind of depend on who I'd be living with.
Oh, I hear you.
I can't imagine, because when I was in the house, people were relatively nice.
Mm.
And there's some people now that I probably want to suffocate while they sleep.
Right. Yeah. That would make a good show,
That would make a good show if I murdered someone. Yeah. Could be a secret task.
Okay, big question.
Ooh,
big one. Who do you think is going to win this year?
Okay, you ready?
Yes.
Now, previous winner.
Oh yes. Brian Daly,
coming
previous
from a winner,
winner,
folks, this okay. is it.
Here we go. Get a pencil and paper because you want to write this down.
Okay, here we go. Final three.
Yes.
John James.
Mm-hmm.
Josie.
Yeah.
Corin.
Oh.
Final two.
Two.
Yep.
John James.
John James.
Josie.
Josie.
Winner.
Oh, tell us.
Josie.
Whoa! You heard it here, folks.
You heard it here, folks.
You heard it here first.
Yes,
I'm coming
indeed.
To get you. I'd love to say that. I'm coming to get you.
Well, do you know, it's been absolutely brilliant to meet you, but it's time to say goodbye to the only gay in the prop room.
Have a look around, babe. There's loads of us here.
It's Brian Daly, everyone. Woo!
Brian!
Would Victoria Beckham be asking of Brian Dowling? That's what I want to know. Let me tell you, Darth Naga is not playing around here.
You're really not,
J2K just looked round and he was like, hang on a minute, this is a fix. Someone's taking away the food. Darth, you are putting it back.
It's good, man.
Yeah.
Really
I think
hot.
You've just moved stuff around your plate.
I'm on the ropes. Now, you know what it is? I've tasted everything. I've tried it all.
Yeah.
But it's killing me, man.
How's the chilies? The chili con carne's the sick one, isn't it?
That's the madness, right?
Chili con carne's insane.
Really? You've got a bit of a face sweat going on
now, major. Major.
Yeah? Good. Well, you've not broken out into a sweat yet, J2K.
Because I've just got to pace it.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
He's taking his time, guys. He's absolutely taking his time.
Right, after the break, I'll be fighting for my 7th BBLB rosette in that game show thing, and Lucy Jones will be joining us. Make sure you do too. I'm now joined by a lady whose shock departure from last year's X Factor resulted in 3,000 viewer complaints. It's Wales's favourite warbler, Lucy Jones.
Hello.
Hi. How are you?
I'm well, thank you. How are you?
I'm good. Is it nice being up here? Big Brother compound?
Yeah, when I came in, I was like looking out the dressing room window and I was like, it's the house.
It's mad, isn't it?
It's amazing.
Just get them to take you on a little tour inside.
Oh, my God, I wish.
So let's talk about Friday and Joe getting kicked out. Do you think the right person went of the four?
I do think that, yeah. I think Jo, she was all right, but she's a nice girl. But there's just much bigger characters in there and more entertaining.
Yeah, she was kind of getting a little bit lost, wasn't
yeah,
she?
Yeah, a little bit.
So Josie's got a free pass to the final. We've got just over a week left of Big Brother 11. Who would you like to see joining her?
I'd like to see Corinne there.
Yeah?
I'd like to see Corinne be right to the end with Josie as the final two. I think that'd be really
nice. So you're
nice.
A big Corinne fan?
Yeah.
Who else?
She's buzzing.
She's buzzing. I'm loving it. Who else would you like to see there?
Sam Pepper, because of the entertainment.
Yeah. Sam Pepper fan at the back.
Sam Pepper fan at the back, yeah.
Right, OK, so Simon Cowell chose, controversially, Jedward over you in X Factor.
Yeah.
There have been some controversial evictions, I think, in the house due to saving the place. So do you think it's fair that people get kicked out that aren't necessarily up for nomination in the first place?
Yeah, I think... no matter how you get put up for eviction, in the end, the public vote for who they don't want to be there anymore. So it's still fair. But also, it's Big Brother, twists and turns all along the way. You've got to be prepared for it. So, yeah, I think it is fair.
Expect the unexpected,
expect
people.
The unexpected.
You're currently appearing as Cosette in the West End, in Les Mis.
Yeah.
So how is life differing for you from, you know, reality television to now being a star on the West End stage?
Well, Les Mis is a bit full on. It's 8 shows a week and it's tiring, and but... everyone in it is so talented, and I'm so lucky to be surrounded by those people, honestly. Yeah. If any of them are watching, hello.
So you're loving it, and you're buzzing.
I'm buzzing like, it, I'm buzzing.
Just like Corinne. Now, I've got to ask you about the rumours of romance with your co-star.
Oh,
Nick Jonas.
There's
what's going on there, then? Because, you know, we love a Big Brother romance, and, you know, there's not much of one going on in there. So if you could kind of do it in
I'm sorry,
some way,
I can't help. I really can't help. There was absolutely nothing going on with us. He's a really nice guy, but there was nothing like that between us.
Really?
I promise.
I'm trying to see which way our eyes go, because apparently you lie if they go a certain way.
No, I'm joking.
Right, OK. I really want to know. Speaking of Les Mis... no, let's not speak about Les Mis. Let's talk about the house. People say they're going to go in and kind of blow the roof off the joint and be all controversial. And then they go in there and they don't really do anything. And a lot of them get quite miserable.
Yeah.
So what is it about life in the house that changes them, do you think?
I don't know. I think being together for so long and not spending time with anyone else, you would go mad after a while.
Yeah.
But I think they forget kind of how lucky they are to be in that situation. And when they come out, probably some of them will look back and go, oh, why didn't I appreciate it more? And,
What do you think of Sam Pepper? Because everybody is talking about him at the moment.
Sam Pepper is like Marmite. I think you love him or you hate him. And I think if I was in there, I'd hate him. But I find him really entertaining being on the outside. But
do you not think you'd find him slightly endearing if you were in there?
Yeah, I mean, the other night when
we've seen
when
his vulnerable
he got
upset, side.
With John James, I mean, I did feel sorry for him. And I was kind of like, oh, no,
poor silly little. Although I did feel sorry for John James as well, actually, at the end of it. Now, we know how he likes to annoy people.
Yes.
And it seems that in Sam's world, it's never too early in the day to annoy people. Take a look at this.
Babe, Sam, what are you doing? Sam, give us our quilt back. Give us a quilt back, please.
All you want, tardy, Dave. Go away. I'm not in the mood to talk to you.
I think he was a good boost to the house, isn't
he? Yeah, he was. He kind of livened everything up a little bit, didn't he? And
I can imagine that living with Sam Pepper is not that dissimilar to living with Jedward.
You say
how
that.
How did you cope with that?
I think they're similar, but for different reasons, if that makes any sense. Like, Jedward don't know they're being annoying and being funny, and they're just getting on with their life, and they're like, oh, hi, guys, yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah.
But Sam does it deliberately, and he'll go up to you and he'll poke you until you scream at him.
Yeah.
And I think that's the difference. That would be what would drive me mad.
What did you think of Jedward's performance in the house?
Ignore the obvious, task was brilliant, by the way, but I thought it was hilarious. Only Jedward could set off the fire alarm.
Exactly. Lucy, thank you so much.
Thanks
we
for
are going to be
me.
Meeting again very shortly in that game show thing, but for now, Lucy Jones. Right, it's that part of the show where I like to ask,
who lives in a town like this?
This housemaid likes to come to the beach to kick back and enjoy the weather. Pleasant. My mate loves their collection of caps. If you take one off them, they'll lose the plot.
This housemate comes here once a week to train. Their favourite activity is boxing.
This housemate comes to my fish and chip shop once a week and they order deep-fried veggie roll.
This is the nightclub. This housemate likes to throw some shapes and pull some moves.
This housemate has a gingerbread man tattooed on their leg. I know this because I did it.
This housemate loves energy drinks.
This is the housemate we've all been talking about. Sam.
Little Sammy Pepper there. Now, you all know what time it is, didn't you?
Yeah! Yeah.
Coming up to 10 past 12. Welcome to that game show thing, everybody. Emma Willis is finally living up to her potential in life and is currently destroying her competition 6-3. Let's see if this week's victims can put a stop to her reign of terror. It's Joe and Lucy Jones, everybody. Let me tell you about round one. Round one this week is called...
Are you buzzing?
Yeah?
Are you buzzing?
Are you buzzing? Are you buzzing? It works like this. Here we have three mysterious BB9 housemates, which Emma is casing out at the moment.
She's probably already figured
out who they are because she's so incredibly competitive. Every time I make a slip up on this here puzzle, our mysterious housemates will get a shot. All you have to do is identify who they are by the sound of their little piggy squeals. Look, okay, buzz when you think you have the answer. Hang on a minute, here we go. Right, let's get busy. Right, here we go. Who do we think they could be?
Okay, I know two and three, but I don't know one.
We just do one at a time. Make it, half a game for everybody.
Two, I think, is Lisa.
Let's see if it's Lisa, everybody. Yeah! Yeah! Carry on. Right, here we go. I'll take that, Lucy.
Number three, is it Mikey?
Let's have a look if it's Mikey. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Well done, Lucy Jones. Right, okay, here we go. Last one, here we go.
Is that Mo?
Let's have a look and see who it is.
Yeah!
Thanks very much, guys. Off you go. Well done. Well done, everybody. So at the end of that round, Emma has two and Lucy and Joe have one. Now, right, we're on to round two, everybody. Round two this week is called Wham Bam, Middle Aged and Glam, in honour of our evictee, Joe. All of this week's questions are about the Cougars who have prowled the corridors of the Big Brother house. Can you test your buzzers, please?
Give it a good whack.
OK? Right, here we go, girls. First up, which busty BB7 housemate made Glynn's dreams come true during a game? Emma?
Leah.
Yeah, absolutely right. Who in Series 9 was surprised to see her boyfriend re-enter the house and propose to her?
Nori.
No, I'll pass that over. BB9, who went back in? Lisa, you say, well done, girl.
Oh,
yeah! Who in the current series was chosen to enter the...
Show?
Yes.
I didn't even know about myself.
Oh, well. Emma's won again. Join us after the break when Roll Deep will be performing and we'll be talking Ultimate Big Brother. Can begin. There's a small matter of kicking out this year's bunch. Josie may have guaranteed herself a place in the final, but no one else is safe because on Friday, not one, not two, not three, but four housemates will be evicted. Yeah, I am serious, very serious. They've got no idea. Here are the all-important numbers you need to vote.
To evict Andrew, call 09011-323-015. To evict Corin, call 09011-323-003. To evict Dave, call 09011-323-004. To evict JJ, call 09011-323-018. To evict John James, call 09011 323 007. To evict Mario, call 09011 323 009. To evict Sam, call 09011 323 020. To evict Steve, call 09011 323 013. Calls cost 50p from a BT landline, other networks may be higher, and mobiles will cost considerably more. 15p from each call will be donated to charity. Details and terms at channel4.com/Big Brother. Voting closes in Friday's show.
Welcome back. The time is 12:14, and here to talk to us about Ultimate Big Brother is I'm going to do that for the rest of the next 2 weeks. Is a lady who's something of an expert on all things BB.
She's written a Big Brother column for The Guardian and interviewed celeb housemates Alex Reid, Jeremy Edwards and Mark Owen. It's The Observer magazine's deputy editor, Polly Hunt. Polly, how are you doing?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
Very good. We're into our final week.
Yes, we are.
We've got 9 housemates. Are you happy with them all?
Yeah, I mean, by and large, I am. I think there's some brilliant people in there. I think we lost some really good people, and it's a shame. I miss Shabby, I miss Kiva, I miss Ben.
Yeah.
And I'm sad that they're not there. But yeah, we've still got some nice people.
There's still some decent guys there.
There are some decent guys.
Davina dropped an absolute bombshell on Friday night. Shall we remind ourselves of that?
Let's.
The final of Big Brother 2010 is actually in 11 days' time, on August the 24th.
What?
Big Brother is giving you the chance to pick one housemate to get a ticket to that final.
It's Josie to get the pass.
But there is more.
Oh, no.
The winner will also re-enter the Big Brother house to compete in Ultimate Big Brother.
Oh, my God.
Shut the front door.
So do you think they were right to pick Josie?
I think they're absolutely right to pick Josie. I don't think it could have been anyone else, really. She's adorable. She's wonderful. Of course she should be there.
I would have liked him to put Sam Pepper through.
Would you?
Yeah, man, he's great.
Yeah, I'm not on Team Sam Pepper. Don't
really?
Get it. Immune, yeah.
Really?
Just.
You don't want to see him in the final?
Yeah, no, I'd like to see him in the final. I would like to see him in the final, but not at the expense of Josie, you know, if anyone had to go through it, it had to be her. No
doubt. So you want Josie to win, then?
I want Josie to win, absolutely.
Oh, it's a resolute Team Josie over there. Now, obviously, there's been a big advert running on Channel 4 with all the potential housemates who could or could not be going back into the house. Who would you like to see going back into Ultimate?
I'd like to see Glenn going in, because
yeah.
I thought it was adorable. I'd actually really like to see Noreen going, because I'd like to see if she could work her magic on all manner of humans. I'd love to watch that over again, her man with some
techniques. It was incredible what she did last year or the year before, right?
Massively impressive. I've never seen anything like it, and I'd like to watch and kind of pick up some tips, honestly.
Who would be your ultimate Big Brother champion?
Well, my ultimate Big Brother champion, quite controversially, would be Nasty Nick, no question.
Really?
I think. I think nobody created that much drama, and it was such a perfect, pure little story.
Do you think Ultimate Big Brother is a kind of fitting end to a televisual phenomenon?
Yes, I do, and I think it could potentially be hilarious.
It's going to be great fun, right?
Explosive and disastrous.
The Ultimate Housemates, they've kind of all tasted fame already, so what do you think it's going to be like when, you know, they go back in there? Is it going to be a house full of egos, do you think? Especially because they're going in with celeb ex-housemates as well.
I hope it's a house full of egos, I really do. I can't wait to see the kind of tensions that will undoubtedly correct. It's going to be amazing.
What do you think the mix is going to be like of, you know, so you might have, you've got some Big Brother 11, you know, people in there, all the winners in there, and then you've got a bunch of celebrity Big Brother people, and then you've got some, you know, just some people from various series. It's going to be quite an odd mix in there.
Yes, it's going to be a potent mix, isn't it? I mean, I'd quite like to see a big celebrity versus non-celebrity divide. I'd like to see hierarchies and...
And what about Chantelle and Preston? Because everybody's saying they might be getting back together in the house.
Well, that'd be lovely, wouldn't it? Yeah, I'm all about that. That'd be very good to see.
Any other Big Brother couples you'd like to see go back in?
Well, they're not necessarily a couple, but I think Craig and Anthony together again might be quite, you know, delicious, no? Look, possibly a bit dangerous.
That's just what he needs, actually.
Polly, thank you so much. Infuriatingly, we have got 9 whole sleeps before we find out who is going to be going in. I'm so excited, though. In the meantime... Oh, stop it. Sorry, that was really hard. In the meantime, we'll just have to keep on wondering. And for any news, you will obviously hear it here first. Give it up for Polly, everyone.
Now, a couple of weeks ago, we gave you the chance to become Big Brother in a brand new item called Housemates Question Time. Hundreds of you submitted queries for our housemates, and here are some of our favourites.
If you had a wizard's wand in the house, what would be the first three things you'd do with it?
The first thing I would do is I would magically make a hairstylist appear to cut and style my hair. My second, I would magically teleport my dog Annie into the house for an hour so I could see her. And the last thing I would do is magic up the new Twilight movie Eclipse onto the telly so I could watch that.
What would you nickname everyone in the house?
I would nickname Dave a raving loony, Corin buzzing, John James Skippy. I know he don't like it.
Which is your favourite tattoo and why?
Yeah, it's got to be my comedy bomb on my arm, which states that I survived on the 10th of May 1989. It's sort of a satirical look at life, and I think that's probably, that's probably helped me through a lot of things.
Would you rather have Watsits for lips or Quavers for a nose?
Oh my God, that is so funny. Watsits for lips or Quaver nose? Watsits for lips or a Quaver nose? I'd probably have Watsits for lips. Yeah, I would.
So if you fancy asking one of the housemates a question of your very own, then head to the website and you can find out how.
I'm afraid that's all we've got time for this afternoon. Make sure you check out the main show tonight at 9 p.m. on Channel 4 and join us over on E4 tomorrow at 6 p.m. with MTV's Laura Whitmore, when we'll be revealing all about the latest task in the house and finding out what the housemates' birth dates tell us about them.
Right, now to play us out with their brand new single, Green Light, it's Roll Deep.
Take it to the floor. You already gave me the green light, baby. Put your glass up, pour a little more. You already gave me the green light.
Look, I was looking for the green light. Who's gonna take me home? Yeah, she might. The night's too young and I wanna have fun. So I'ma keep going till the party's done. You know I love women. Which one's gonna control me? Cause I wanna be your one and only. You know I love women. Which one's gonna control me? Cause I wanna be your one and only.
I follow the green cross code, then I cross the road. I follow the saints, then I follow my nose. Seek out my princess, tweak on the phone. Eventually, I'll treat with a stone. No regular seats, I get the thrown out. His and her match, we're going all out. Got crown and my crown, we're gonna ball out. Take my time, I won't stall out.
Stop. Take a look.
Take a look.
Left and right.
Left and right.
Is it clear for me to go?
Let me know.
Let me know.
Let me know.
Is it me that you've been waiting?
I thought, wow, so check out the skirt on that, not sure. Straight to the bar, tequila, lemon, salt. I give her the all clear, letting her know. Green light, I'm letting her go. Got her from a mile away, and I thought to myself, why not give it a go? You know, like what I see. See, her face all lit up like a Christmas tree. It's amazing the way she goes. Never knows what clouds she fell from. Jeez, that's a bit high above the knee. But I know that twinkle in her eyes for me. Said, just show me a signal, she flashed red, amber, green.
Stop, take a look.
Take a look,
yes. Left and right.
Left and right.
Is it clear for me to go?
Let me know.
Let me know.
Let me know.
Is it me that you've been waiting for?
We say,
for?
We say, hey.
Put your hands up.
Put your hands up.
Take it to the floor.
Take it to the floor.
You already gave
Trust
me the green light.
I'm giving you the green light.
Put your glass up.
Put your glass
pour
up.
A little more.
Pour a little more.
You already gave
Take to the wheel.
make one smile in a drink. I say a couple words and she might be a link. I like the fact that she ain't wearing a ring. And she ain't looking at him with a perfect match. What a good catch. She's 10 out of 10. I've got to keep that. She's so far gone. The green light's on. I ain't gonna turn.
It's a wrap.
Stop. Take a look.
Take a look.
Left and right.
Left and right.
Is it clear for me to go?
Let me know.
Let me know.
Let me know.
Is it me that you've been waiting for?
Yeah.
Put your hands up.
Your hands
take
up.
It to the floor.
Take it to the floor.
You already gave me the green light,
I'll give you the green light.
Put your glass up. Put
your glass
pour
up.
A little more.
Pour a little more.
You already gave me the green light.
I'll give you the green light.
Put your hands up.
Put your hands
take
up.
It to the floor.
Take it to the floor.
You already gave me the green light.
I'll give you the green light.
So put your glass
up. Put your glass
up. Pour a little more. See you.